Over 1 billion wireless earbuds were sold last year, most of them on repairable junk, dead as soon as the batteries go bad. Can we count on Google to shake up the market? Now, Google has been on a hot repairability streak in recent years, beefing up the repairability on their phones by offering OEM parts and manuals, and even creating the most repairable smartwatch currently on the market, the amazingly innovative Pixel Watch 4. I would love to see Google disrupt the earbud market. Nearly all the earbuds on the market have glued-in seams and no path to replace the battery, and that battery will eventually go bad. There are a few good eggs in the earbud market: the Fairbuds, Samsung's Galaxy Buds Live, and the PQ earbuds with detachable stems. All of these have replaceable batteries, but most earbuds go the way of Apple's glued-shut AirPods. So in today's Teardown, what I want to know is this: did Google's engineers design the Pixel Buds 2a with repairability in mind? Well, sort of yes, but mostly no. Let me show you what I mean. These buds, as with so many others we've seen, are glued shut around the seams of the driver. That means we need to find a jig that can hold it, pull out the rework station, and carefully heat the seam to pry it open. Obviously, this is not a repair you can expect the average person to perform, and the Pixel Buds 2a fall flat on their unrepairable face right from the get-go. Once the housing is opened up, I can see a gasket running around the outer edge that seems to hint at a repairable design, but honestly, it's already far too late. That's only made worse once I realize the battery is glued in, requiring far too much force to remove, and no amount of isopropyl alcohol or heat is going to change that. The damage to the outer casing and the battery itself tells you everything you need to know about the feasibility of a DIY repair. But here's the thing, there's evidence that a replaceable battery might have been in the cards once upon a time. The 0.297 watt-hour cell uses two prongs to connect the positive and negative terminals to the rest of the circuitry. There's no press connector here, meaning the battery was designed to be removable. Except with all that glue and the uber-tight tolerances, there's no way it could actually come out. It's almost like they ran out of time to figure out the engineering challenge and just said, "It's good enough, ship it." It's disappointing. But wait, the Google Pixel Repair Manual site has a battery replacement guide for the Pixel Buds 2a. What's that about? Oh, it's just for the case. Where the buds failed to deliver, the case stands in stark contrast as a shining example of designing for repairability. You can see two strategically placed torque screws on the inside of the case and not a drop of glue in sight. The case just slides out buttery smooth. The gasket provides the IPX4 rating, which means you're fine running in the rain with it, but maybe don't jump into the pool, which is more than enough for most people. And check this out, no screws, no tools, the battery pops out using this nifty pull tab. Now how cool is that? The 1.53 watt-hour cell requires the removal of two screws where the Fairbuds battery case required one, but it outdoes the Fairbuds by making the port and board replaceable with the removal of just two screws and a single press connector. And that's it, job done. Pack up and go home, this Teardown is finished. So what to make of the Pixel Buds 2a? After the iPad M5 Teardown, this device feels like even more of a repair paradox, or what our commenters are calling a repairadox. It seems clear the design team were given a repairability target to hit, and they totally nailed the case side of the device, but on the buds, well, they were a little wide of the mark. The promise is there, and I'm excited to see how these design choices will carry over to the next generation of buds, and if the release of manuals and parts are anything to go by, the long-term commitment to sustainability is hopefully here to stay. As for the device in front of us, it earns a provisional repairability score of 4 out of 10. If you're looking for a repairable and long-lasting set of wireless earbuds, maybe give the Pixel Buds 2a a miss. Here's hoping the next iteration of the Pixel Buds finally has replaceable batteries.